I should be feeling a little bit bad. You know, I got a little bit of a boo-boo Sunday night. I bled a little bit Sunday night, but man, it's okay. I'm feeling good, homie. I feel great. I'm in Las Vegas. It's the capital of lying, cheating, and stealing, homie. Now, Bradshaw, you may have taken a lot out of me on Sunday night, Judgment Day, Holmes. But you know what you didn't take, Issa? You didn't take my WWE Championship, Vato Loco. No, Holmes, you kind of left empty-handed, but I didn't. See, when I was in the back, I kind of wanted a souvenir to remind me of the day. What? So I stole a little bit of a souvenir.
Bradshaw's hat.
Bloodied hat.
Look at the stitches in the forehead of Eddie Guerrero.
Humongous wound.
Your hat, my blood, Holmes. I guess this belongs to me, Ese. So I can do with your hat whatever the hell I want to. I got a little itch. Orale, mamacita! John! JBL, you know what, Holmes? I'm feeling so good, I'm gonna give you a little stock tip, Ese. You should invest. I want you to hear this very good now. Go do your investments. Go place your investments on a lot of bandages and a lot of hospital gowns, Holmes, because you're going to need it after tonight.
Tonight?
How about that?
I'm not going to be satisfied until I beat you 1, 2, 3 in this ring, S.A. Let's cut the talk and let's walk the walk, Holmes. Get your ass on out here right now and let's get down, because I'm going to kick your ass right here, right now, tonight in Las Vegas. Orale!
I can't believe Eddie Guerrero has called out Bradshaw.
I don't think this is smart, in my opinion here, Cole. The condition.
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute. But I think Eddie got the worst of it.
It's bad business to stay up there, Issa. Come on.
So let me get this straight, Eddie. You want a match with me again tonight? And you want to put that title on the line tonight, right here, right now?
Are you deaf? Did you get too much blood in your ears, Holmes? Yeah, you know what I said, Issa. Come on.
I got one easy answer for you, Eddie. No.
Oh, come on, Bradshaw.
You don't get it, do you, you thick-headed idiot? I guaranteed last week that I would beat you at Judgment Day. And just like I always do, Eddie, I delivered. The record books will forever be etched in stone that on May 16th, 2004, Staples Center, Judgment Day. John Bradshaw Layfield beat you, Eddie Guerrero. I beat you, Eddie. I put you in the hospital.
That
facing
he did.
You right now, Eddie, the loose cannon that you are is an unnecessary risk. That's a gamble. I don't gamble. Gambling is for lazy, simple-minded people who want an easy payoff. I did not make my fame and my fortune by gambling, Eddie. I earned it, just like I earned that WWE Championship. So you do the fair thing, Eddie. You do the right thing. You be the man that you claim that you are, that your mama raised you to be, and you walk down that aisle, and you give me my championship. What do you mean to say it in Mexican? I said, you walk down that aisle and give me what is mine, the WWE Championship, now, or I will make you bleed some more, Eddie. I will put you back in the hospital.
You know what, Holmes? You're right. I'm going to show everybody what a great man my mom raised. I said, I'm going to go down and hand you what you deserve, a good kicking.
Oh, boy.
Well, Eddie, think this over, Eddie.
Well, Eddie, wait a minute.
Well, it's official. Everybody's lost their minds. Eddie, I know you lost a lot of blood last Sunday, and it's obviously made you a little lightheaded, you know, a little loco. And it's caused you to believe for some reason that you can put the matches together, that you make the matches. Well, listen to me, SA. I make the matches around here. I'm the general manager. You see, Eddie, this is where being a self-proclaimed liar gets you in trouble. You say you want to be Bradshaw 1, 2, 3.
Oh, I'm not lying about that.
Well, we all know that that's just an excuse so you can get him back in the ring and beat him senseless with whatever you can get your hands on and get yourself disqualified again. Well, your request for a rematch between you and JBL has been officially denied.
Oh, oh hey, what are you talking about, SA? No, man. No.
He said official. That means not gonna happen, Eddie. Now give me my belt.
Now, John.
Listen to me. Nothing would please me more than to force Eddie Guerrero to hand that title over to you tonight. But we all know that the board of directors would never go for it. Now listen, the good news is, I know the good news is, tonight, I'm gonna give you a chance to finish what you started at Judgment Day. Because tonight, it will be John Bradshaw Layfield teaming up with the Dudley Boys to take on Rey Mysterio, Rob Van Dam, and Eddie Guerrero.
Oh, my!
Oh, man!
Did you get these staples?
Eddie Guerrero hit me with an illegal steel chair.
Are we done?
Yes.
Whatever.
Speaking of Eddie Guerrero, he's going to come in here later, right?
Yes.
Now, he's going to tell you about his little concussion. He's going to tell you about all this blood he supposedly lost at Judgment Day. He's going to tell you about the fact that he spent the night in the hospital. Don't you listen to a word he says. Eddie Guerrero is a damn liar.
Please the hot. General Manager Kurt Angle determined this matchup. Wait a minute.
Oh, what's this?
I'm afraid I have some bad news. Apparently, Eddie Guerrero would rather stay in the back and fake some injury than to come out here and perform for you people tonight. Well, guess what, Eddie? That's not going to cut it. I won an Olympic gold medal with a broken neck. You sure as hell could come out here and wrestle. So, Eddie, when you finally decide to wake up from your siesta or recover from your so-called injury, you can join in on this match because it will begin with or without you. And the match begins right now.
Now you gotta be kidding me.
Oh, don't Bubba stop
him. Can Mysterio get there? He does.
Oh,
here
man.
Comes Eddie.
Here we go. Back down the hatches.
The WWE Champion unloading on Devon Dudley. Eddie is on fire.
Like a house of fire. Cole, look at him.
Latino Heat all fired up. There goes Devon. Off the big back body drop.
Like the punch. Right hand. Another right hand. Another one.
The right hand.
Feeling it, baby.
Eddie is feeling it big time. Suplex connects.
Eddie Guerrero now looks like he hasn't missed a beat. Cole.
And there's that Devon. Going for that triple vertical suplex.
Three amigos. There's one. Boom. There's two.
Can Eddie lock it in a third time?
How is he doing this, Cole?
The champion is all fired up. Latino Heat.
Amazing.
Has come to play tonight.
Fired up. What?
Wait a minute. What?
Bradshaw covering Eddie. It's not about winning and losing right now. It's about that man's health, Eddie Guerrero.
What's going on? What happened?
I have no idea. I've never seen Eddie like this, and...
Mr. Layfield, considering the severity of Eddie Guerrero's medical condition, many people that I've spoken with over the past week were appalled at your actions. The fact of the matter that you tagged yourself into the matchup, that you covered Eddie Guerrero, and then you forced the referee to count the 1, 2, 3. And as I stand in the ring here tonight, I need to ask you this question. After seeing that, what kind of a man are you?
Don't you ever question my manhood, Michael Cole. I will slap you in the next week. I tell you what kind of man I am. I'm a businessman. A smart, very rich businessman. I see an opportunity, I seize that opportunity. That's how I have made a fortune on Wall Street. I see things most people don't. That is why CNBC loves me. That is why my radio show is the buzz of the industry. I hesitated before I pinned Eddie Guerrero because I did not know what Eddie Guerrero was up to. Would I take advantage of an injured man? Hell yeah. And most of you wouldn't. That is what is wrong with America. You are weak. I am not. There is nothing, and there was nothing, wrong with Eddie Guerrero. He was lying, just like his mother lied a few weeks ago in El Paso.
Mrs. Guerrero had a heart attack.
Eddie Guerrero did not want to take another beating from me like he took at Judgment Day. So he laid there. He laid there like a lying, sniveling coward. What a horrible representative as a WWE champion. He simply did not want another beating, so he laid there and let me pin him. The coward. The beating I gave Eddie Guerrero at Judgment Day has become legendary. Blood was pouring from Eddie Guerrero like water from a faucet. But guess what, Eddie? At the Great American Bash, what I'm gonna do to you is gonna be damn near criminal. And you know what makes me mad? Is some of you people out here, you're so damn simple-minded. You actually believe. This isn't a sing-along, boys, sit down. You actually believe.
The Eddie chance getting to Bradshaw.
You should have sent him a card to his hospital room. Now shut up. I am not finished. When JBL talks, you listen.
happen? Some of you people actually believe that Eddie was hurt. Are you stupid or blind? Eddie Guerrero lies. That's what he was born to do. Eddie Guerrero took the WWE title, brought it in the ring at Judgment Day, and hit me with it for one reason, to get disqualified because I had him beat.
Bradshaw brought the title in the ring.
I beat Eddie Guerrero. That WWE championship is mine. Well, Eddie's games have now ended. Kurt Angle has told me that I, John Bradshaw Layfield, get the name, the stipulation for the match at the Great American Bash.
What?
So I'm gonna take a week and I'm gonna think about how I'm gonna beat Eddie. And I promise you this, Eddie, you nor all your fans will like what I choose. Because this time, it's my game. It's my rules. Think of the name of the pay-per-view, Eddie. It is the Great American Bash. I will bash you into oblivion, and I will get what is rightfully mine. I will take the WWE Championship home with me to New York City.
And he's got a temper, and you know what? In that instance, I don't blame Eddie there. You got him, man.
Eddie Guerrero, look at Eddie. Whoa, whoa. Latino heat fired up. Eddie Guerrero, the right hand to Danny Basham.
It's a handicap match.
Well, it's supposed to be a one-on-one matchup. And Eddie looking good. And look at there goes Dunn up over the top rope.
Let's see if Eddie can go through this whole matchup here. Again, he looked good last week.
Wait a minute.
That's Mr. Angle.
What is the general manager doing out here?
Whoa, 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 whoa. Nice try, Eddie. I almost fell into your trap. But I was just tipped off, and I know what you're up to. You see, I just realized that I'm not only responsible for your safety and well-being, I'm also legally responsible. And I know what you're gonna do tonight. You were gonna take on Danny Basham, and then you were gonna fake another injury, and then sue me. Well, I'm not gonna allow you to do that to me or to this show. You're not gonna wrestle tonight or any other night. In fact, you will not wrestle again until you sign a hold harmless release, which clears me of any liability should you get injured in the ring again. Now get the hell out of my ring.
Eddie Guerrero upset at the treatment by the general manager. And look at Danny Basham.
Oh,
potato heat with the right hands.
Eddie Guerrero.
Long angle, there goes Basham. Over the top rope.
You can see in Eddie's eyes.
I can guarantee you this. June 27th, the Great American Bash in Norfolk, Virginia. Eddie Guerrero is scheduled to fight to defend the WWE Championship against John Bradshaw Layfield. And Bradshaw chooses his
destination. Yes, well, Eddie's ready. Eddie wants to fight. You can see it in that man's eyes. He wants to go. Danny's trying to put some pressure on the head. Nice knee to the gut by Danny to block that.
And the referee's been knocked down.
Driven down.
Danny Basham shoving Eddie Guerrero into the referee, and Danny Basham believes he may have seen an opening here.
I think Danny is going to take advantage of that opening.
Got the WWE Championship in his hands.
Referee is down and out, and Eddie Guerrero knows the ref's out.
Eddie Guerrero better watch it here.
Heads up,
look
Eddie.
Look out, Eddie.
Eddie, heads up, champ.
Basham with the championship. Low blow by Eddie.
Talk about south of the border.
Referee never saw it. Oh! And a shot by Eddie with the championship. Now Eddie falls down. The referee has come to. Danny Basham has been knocked out perhaps with the championship, but Eddie's down as well. Did Eddie black out or is he playing possum? This is eerily reminiscent of a couple of weeks ago when Eddie blacked out in the ring. Look at the glassy look in his eyes. Well, Danny Basham's got to look in his eye as well because he's hit in the head by that championship.
How can you see his eyes? He's covering with his hands.
Good point.
Well, referee's up to six.
And Eddie Guerrero back to his feet quickly. He was playing possum.
Yes, he was, and that smoke tells the story on his face.
And Eddie Guerrero going to go up high to the top rope.
And he's feeling good. Eddie's also feeling froggy.
Frog splash connecting to Danny Basham. Here's the cover.
Two.
The champion lying and cheating and stealing again. Eddie is back.
Here's your winner, the WWE champion, Eddie Guerrero.
Eddie Guerrero looking good there in that victory. Hard fought battle by Danny Basham. But that man right there, and Eddie Guerrero, still WWE champion. And he's still up to his old shenanigans, called Lion King and Steel.
I'm from America. You treat me with just a little bit of respect. On May 16th, 2004, John Bradshaw Layfield defeated Eddie Guerrero at Judgment Day. I should be WWE champion. The only reason I am not is because Eddie Guerrero is a lying, cheating coward. A coward that got himself intentionally disqualified because he knew that I had him beat. You know, this was just business. It's now become personal. And personal's okay with me. You see, Kurt Angle has allowed me, John Bradshaw Layfield, to name the kind of match that Eddie and I will have for the WWE Championship at the Great American Bash. And I promise you, the match I have chose, Eddie Guerrero will not like. Because the match I chose, Eddie Guerrero cannot run, he cannot hide, and he cannot get disqualified because there are no disqualifications. This match is personal to me because I grew up with this match. The Texas Bull Rope match. You think Judgment Day was brutal? When Eddie Guerrero bled his little Latino blood all over the Staples Center? When I put Eddie Guerrero in the hospital? That is a walk in the park, a picnic to what's going to happen at the Texas Bull Rope match at the Great American Bash. You see, it's real simple. Even you simple-minded Canadians can understand this. I told you I'm from America. We protect you. You treat me with respect. One man ties his hand to the one end of the rope. The other man ties his hand to the other. And from there, it's fair game. Anything goes. You can use the cowbell, which is sharp. And Eddie is a bleeder. But blood won't stop this match. You see, what stops this match is when you got a man beat senseless. And you wrap the rope around his neck, you wrap the rope around his legs, or you just drag his unconscious carcass from pillar to post until you touch all four corners. And that is when the person who does that becomes WWE champion. To drag a man that far means that you have beat him senseless. there will be a clear and decisive winner in this match, and there will be a definite loser. And that will be you, Eddie Guerrero, because I am not just going to beat you. I am going to humiliate you. My destiny awaits me at the Great American Bash, because that is the day that John Bradshaw Layfield becomes WWE Champion.
Welcome back, Mr. Layfield. How are you tonight?
Doing great, Bruce.
Good.
How's the missus?
Very good, thanks. Please, right this way.
Here's your dollar. Buy a donut.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Relax, Mr. Layfield. You are in good hands.
Best hands money can buy, Joseph.
Of course.
I knew immigrants were good for something. Jose, you missed a spot. Get it. You don't even speak English, do you? Arriba. Andale. Jose, I wish all your people worked this hard. You should be proud of yourself. Man, the INS would have a field day in here.
Joseph, who said money doesn't buy happiness?
Jose, what do you see? I tell you what you see. You see the best looking, richest WWE champion of all time, John Bradshaw Layfield. Wow.
Far from Manhattan, so you know he's not far from Long Island. But what?
You know, this place really is a toxic waste dump of New York. And I look way too good to be here, driver. So I'll tell you what, these people don't get to see John Bradshaw Layfield today. Why don't you take me home, back to New York City?
Oh, come on.
Well, sometimes the ocean in Jones Beach can have a little odor. It could.
A rich man doesn't work when a rich man doesn't want to. Let's go, driver. I look way too good not to be in New York City tonight. Let's go. Hey, let's go. Idiot!
Goodness, who hired these morons?
Hey, moron! I said let's go! Take me back to New York City now!
New York City?
Hey! Whoa! It's Eddie!
What are you doing? What are you, Holmes? We ain't going to New York City, but we are going for a ride. And it's gonna be better than Disneyland! Orale, Hulk! Does this thing have any hydraulics? Yeah, vato loco!
What do you mean, hydraulics? Get out of my car! You stole my car! Eddie!
I'm letting
you arrest and get out of my car!
Oh my!
Oh my god!
Oh! Eddie's taking the limo for a toy ride!
What the hell's he gonna do with JBL?
You hear he asked about hydraulics? I think Eddie believes the limo's a lowrider.
Smashing into stuff!
And JBL is locked in the back of a limo that Eddie's driving!
Viva la raza!
And we were right! Here comes the WWE Champion driving JBL's limousine!
Yeah, that is not a lowrider! Whatever's left of that limousine, look at that!
Oh, it's riding pretty low there, partner.
It's a cold sticking out of it. The lights are hanging off of the horns! Oh my god, the long horns!
Well, there's one horn left.
It's not funny, Cole. When I'm sideways, the tie is flat. Yeah, what's funny to you, have? I'll tell you what, that's a lot of money and damage. That man's gonna pay, Guerrero.
On the Great American Bash, Eddie Guerrero, as he has to kick the door open.
He didn't get out of the thing. Well, he wrecked it. I want to recondition of John Bradshaw Layfield. That's what I want to know. People love him.
Well, Eddie's surveying the damage. And look, he's a gentleman. He's opening the door up for JBL.
Opening the door up for him?
He's a great chauffeur.
Yeah, he's a great chauffeur. I guess that's why he's wearing this. Look at this. Look at that.
Where's Bradshaw?
He's passed out. Look at Bradshaw. He's knocked out. Look at the hat. Look at Bradshaw. He's knocked out. Cold, cold. Oh, man. I don't believe it.
You think he'll come to before the Texas Bowl match at the Great American Bash?
Well, the indignity of being knocked out in your own limousine. And earlier today, he went to Salon Federo and had that beautiful makeover and everything. For what?
I think he needs another one.
Yeah, I know. Real funny. And there's the WWE champion, Eddie Guerrero. Hold on, and he's proud of it. Look at JBL. Shocking. Probably has a concussion and everything, Cole. Maybe have a broken rib.
Probably throwing around that limo like a rag doll there for a while.
You think? Wow.
Orale, vatos locos, what's up, NASA? Orale, do I look like a good-looking limousine driver, is it?
It looks great.
I'm not really a pretty boy, is it? So I'm not worried about getting banged up. Hey, John. Bradshaw. Hey, Holmes, did you have a rough night, is it? Because I don't know if you were passed out in the back or just taking a little siesta, ese vato.
He looks like a salad.
This is no way to treat the number one contender, Cole. He doesn't look like a salad.
Bradshaw struggling his way out of the limousine.
Orale, Holmes, it looks like you got a hangover, ese. Get up, Bradshaw! Hey, Holmes. Holmes, you smell a little fishy, S.A. What you been into? You know, Bradshaw, you got a good-looking ride, S.A., but it looks a little banged up, S.A., just like you're gonna look at the Great American Bash. Orale, viva mi raza!
Viva la raza!
So a moment ago, Bradshaw, look at Bradshaw just dancing now his limousine. Shot, he's heartbroken. Oh, one of the horns is gone. I mean, the other one's gone.
I got that passion.
Look at this.
Bradshaw broken up over his limousine. He is absolutely crushed.
That's sad. And Eddie Guerrero loves it. Bradshaw's mortified. Mortified.
I thought it was pretty funny, actually.
Well, of course you would think it's funny. I'll tell you what's not too funny is that man, Eddie Guerrero, at the Great American Bash, in the Texas Bull Rope match, right up JBL's alley, man.
Eddie Guerrero did the damage to the limousine and JBL tonight.
Well, Guerrero's going to go for a ride, all right. Well, and he's the champ, the new champ.
Most of you people are extremely happy that I just had one hell of a week. Not only do I get fired from CNBC, but Eddie Guerrero wrecks my limousine with me in it. And with Ronald Reagan, one of our greatest presidents ever, passing away last week, all the media wants to talk about is me. You people in our media in America are what is exactly wrong with America. Americans are what's wrong with America. You people want me to fail for one reason. Shut up, I'm talking. You people want me to fail because when I was in high school, I'm the one that threw you in a locker. I'm the one that took your girlfriend. I was the captain of the football team. I'm the one that got everything. And it hasn't changed one damn bit now that I'm 37 years old. I am richer than you people. I am better looking than you people. And what makes you mad is I have a backbone. The whole world is against me right now. The media has vilified me. CNBC has fired me. And what makes you people the maddest is I will not beg for a damn thing. I will not crawl. I will not back up. can knock me on my but I will be back, and that makes you people mad, because despite everything, I will come back, and I will be successful. It is what I have done my whole life, and that is why you people hate me. I was raised by a man who had a backbone. So do I. I came in this world alone. I will leave alone. I don't need a damn soul with me. Come hell, come high water, take your best shot, America. John Bradshaw Layfield is right here, and I won't back up from anybody. And if you don't like it, you can go to hell. A year and a half ago, I was a guest of the United States Army in Kandahar, Afghanistan. Where were you? Where were you? Where was our media? You weren't there, were you? I am an American. The night before, a soldier got killed in a firefight. A soldier got killed in a firefight, and what did our media cover? The fact that a man died a hero defending our country? The fact that a man died preserving our freedom in a land he didn't want to be in, thousands of miles away from his family? What are you booing, our American soldiers? Huh? That shows you what kind of American you are, you piece of garbage. Our American media covered one thing that week, and that was the fact that Sean Penn was in Baghdad as a guest of Saddam Hussein's regime in support of Iraq, and they cast it in a positive light. That is the media that guides you like the mindless zombies that you are. Oh, I've been to Iraq now, but I went as a guest of the United States government in support of our troops. Calling me anything but a great American is like calling Mother Teresa a prostitute. I come back last week and find out that I am fired from CNBC. I left Fox News as the guy who appeared on there regularly to CNBC, a ratings that might as well be in the witness protection program to all kinds of dreams. And all of a sudden, after 3 weeks, they realize that I'm a wrestler. Oh my God, I've got a big mouth. Well, you're damn right I've got a big mouth. And there's nothing you nor CNBC can do about it. You see, I might as well take the Fifth Amendment, because the First Amendment does not mean a damn thing in our society anymore. You see, everybody loves free speech until you use free speech. I wondered why you people hated me. Well, now I know, because I expose you for what you are. I am strong. Therefore, you are exposed for the fact that you are weak. I am driven, and that exposes the fact that you are lazy, complacent, and take jobs you do not like because you don't have the guts to speak up. I have a backbone, and that makes you mad. People like me are the ones that founded America. Put that foreign flag down, son. You're in America. Our founding fathers are rolling over in their grave right now at the pathetic example of Americans that you people have become. I am a window, a mirror that makes you look into your own souls, and you don't like what you see. You hate me because I reveal what you are. Well, at the Great American Bash, I'm going to go one step further. I am going to become WWE champion for one reason, and that is to shove it down your throats. Eddie Guerrero, this is past personal. Do you even know what a bull rope match is? There is a reason they don't do bull rope matches anymore. Blood is gonna flow like a river. This will make Judgment Day look like a cartoon. Eddie Guerrero, you have come to represent everything I hate about America. Eddie Guerrero, you personify what I abhor. These people like Eddie Guerrero because Eddie Guerrero asks nothing of them. I condemn you people for your lazy and pathetic lives. You are underachievers, and I say you are wrong, and you hate me because of it. Well, Eddie, if I have to destroy myself to destroy you, then by God in heaven, by everything holy, that is what I will do. Because I don't care if it's you people, I don't care if it's CNBC, I don't care if it's our liberal media, and I damn sure don't care if it's you, Eddie Guerrero. Nobody can stop me from becoming WWE Champion and taking my date with destiny.
Can't wait to see what the Undertaker does to John Cena tonight. It's gonna be fabulous.
Well, well, well. It isn't the next WWE Champion, JBL. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Luther, I just wanted to come in here and tell you what a fantastic job that you are doing as general manager.
Well, thank you very much.
We are so proud of what you're doing, especially considering your physical condition. I mean, you are an example, a shining example to wheelchair-bound people all across the world.
Well, thank you very much, John. So what are you here for? What do you mean?
I saw the way that you handled that disrespectful John Cena. Huh? And I just want to tell you that there's a guy on our SmackDown roster that is, he's like a cancer. He's actually worse than John Cena.
I think I know you're talking about.
Eddie Guerrero. Now, I don't have to remind you how disrespectful he was to you and the way he cheated to win, to beat you at WrestleMania 20. And I think, look, I don't want to tell you how to do your job. You're doing a great job. But in my opinion, making Eddie Guerrero wrestle a match tonight, just 3 days before the Texas Bull Rope match, the Great American Bash, is a great way to teach Eddie a little bit of respect.
I love the idea. I mean, I wish I could do it myself, but with this condition here, I don't...
I'd love to do it, too. I tell you, you know, I...
What do you have in mind?
You know the impressive debut Luther had last week on SmackDown?
Uh-huh.
I think Luther would be a perfect opponent for Eddie Guerrero tonight.
Are you up for it?
Oh, I'm up for it. And by the end of the match, I will teach Eddie Guerrero some respect.
Well then, boys, it's official. Tonight, Eddie Guerrero will go one-on-one against Luther Reigns.
Outstanding.
You said it.
Come on, you gotta be kidding me. How is Eddie Guerrero? And look at Luther Reigns, and the referee Jimmy Cordero's knocked down, and a clothesline.
That's that size and power of Luther Reigns and that short burst of steel. The difference maker, that short clothesline there on Eddie Guerrero.
And Luther Reigns taking control. Referee is down in the matchup. Luther Reigns with Eddie Guerrero on his shoulder. The champion is in all kinds of trouble. We saw Luther Reigns win that matchup with Jackie last week.
It's a miracle.
A miracle?
He's walking.
Look at Kurt Angle.
Yeah.
What the hell was that?
It's a victory.
Eddie Guerrero kicked out. Kurt Angle tried to be the referee, and Eddie Guerrero kicked out.
Oh, hold on now. Kurt Angle's got the right to be the referee. He is the general manager. The referee is down. Now
Luther Reigns just grabbed the title. The WWE Championship. And Angle's blocking orders.
I think Kurt's telling him to put it down.
Missed with the championship. And a low blow by Eddie Guerrero.
Very low blow.
Referee is down. Eddie's got the championship.
Don't do it, Eddie. That's the general manager's handicap.
Come on, champ.
Wait a minute here.
Luther, championship off the skull of Luther Reigns and the general manager in the crosshairs of Latino Heat.
I'm just threatening him, don't do it. Oh, what the?
Look at this. Referee back on his feet.
Oh, man.
He's caught red-handed.
The smoking gun was caught in Kurt Angle's hand. Guerrero did it again.
The referee giving it to our general manager.
I don't believe this.
Eddie Guerrero.
Now what? Uh-oh.
Where's Eddie going?
Oh, look at that grin. You know, Eddie was pretending
Eddie
to be.
The old Eddie Guerrero is back lying and chinned and stealing.
And he's still feeling froggy.
Frog splash connects. Here's the cover.
Whoa.
What? Wait a minute.
Ingenious, beautiful by John Bradshaw Layfield. JBL always thinking.
And that rope wrapped around the neck of the champion. JBL with a peel. That rope wrapped around the neck of Eddie Guerrero.
Well, now Eddie Guerrero's getting an idea what's going to happen this Sunday with that Texas bull rope match. And there's that cowbell in there. And that's the dangerous part.
Well, JBL knows how to use that bull rope. And look at JBL. JBL wrapping it around the neck of Eddie Guerrero.
Yeah, like a noose. Like a navel.
And Latino Heat. Oh, this is not good.
This is definitely not good.
The champion is in a world of trouble. The
JBL
smile on the face of Bradshaw.
JBL's got Guerrero where he wants him.
Eddie Guerrero fighting desperately to catch his breath.
Eddie Guerrero's in trouble here.
Wait a minute. Eddie Guerrero caught Bradshaw.
How'd he do that?
Latino Heat has the bull rope in hand.
But he's hurt. Latino Heat's hurt, Cole.
Bradshaw back to his feet. Latino Heat to his feet as well. And there's the cowbell off the side of the head.
Oh, he also used the rope like a clothesline across the throat of JBL.
And the bull rope again. And John Bradshaw Layfield. Feeling the wrath of Eddie Guerrero and JBL.
Oh, my God, that hurts. Right on his hand. Well, I'll tell you what, looks like Eddie Guerrero was going to use that bull rope. It is Eddie chance.
I thought the bull rope match was a Bradshaw's match.
So did I.
Eddie Guerrero showing he could use the bull rope tonight.
Well, will Eddie Guerrero successfully defend his title this Sunday in Norfolk, Virginia? And also get the opportunity to beat the daylights out of JBL, the Great American Bear? That remains to be seen.
John Bradshaw Layfield, Eddie Guerrero with the WWE title on the line in a Texas bull rope match. There are no pinfalls. There are no disqualifications. Bradshaw will be on one end of the rope. Eddie Guerrero will be on the other end. You beat your opponent senseless till you can drag him and touch all four corners with Eddie Guerrero. Retain the WWE title.